This is Hiroshi Shibe of Satoshi's Treasure Hunters, and this is me talking about the Satoshi Treasure Hunt game. Who did it? What it's about? How to play it? And how you could win? Just your basic, simple EL5. So let's get on the trail. Let's hop onto the hunt. Let's get into this game, and let's talk about Satoshi's Treasure Hunt.
$1 million.
So Satoshi's Treasure is a ARG text-based adventure cryptographic puzzle game with a Bitcoin prize of $1 million USD. So you play this on the internet and in the real world. So let's go to the beginning. A message was sent through a satellite service. I linked to the show notes to that service, as well as a website that keeps track of the satellite messages. They announced the game. Basically, the game maker showed a game. Now I'm getting to the game makers in a moment. Stated that players or Bitcoin hunters have to solve clues and obtain keys in order to earn or win a $1 million in USD equivalent of Bitcoin. These keys were split into 1,000 pieces, so you have a private key to the Bitcoin address. If you obtain 400 pieces, it can be 8,400, it doesn't matter if it's 1, 20, and then 399, and you have 20, 399, and then 420, and 444, and all together, when you have a total of 400, you piece it together, you have access to the Bitcoin address. Go to this website, Satoshi's Treasure Hunters, Satoshi's Treasure, and you obtain your clues, you earn your keys, you fill out the puzzle, you get your keys, you collect your keys, kind of like Pokemon, you piece them all together, and eventually you could, if you have the right amount of 400, win a Bitcoin prize. In the same message, you get geolocation keys. When you went to these locations at the specific date and time, you were able to get these first three set of keys. If you have an understanding of cryptography or development of computers and could hack, you could also obtain these keys without actually being in physical locations. This is the site. So far, there have been a total of 18 keys released. Now, each key with each clue, sometimes these keys actually have more than one attached to them. For example, the hunted key has had. Initially had three keys attached to it, but only one was found. There are two keys that are actually not on the site. You can call them hidden keys. One is called the Art Tour Key, which was from an exhibit in New York that took place in during the month of April. The Business Card Key, in which you had to obtain business cards from the game makers, a total of 18 of them. Three of them reveal themselves. You get all those cards, and then you can get a key. These are the game makers. His name is Ed Meltzer. I highly recommend following his Twitter account. I have a link in the show notes. He's known for having proof of work, the newsletter, cryptocurrency newsletter that keeps up to date a lot of different various cryptocurrency projects. He's also a partner at Primitive Ventures. He and David Wong, who I've heard from the name recently, founded and partners and created this game. It took them about maybe 2 years to develop. They were seeking some kind of way to invest their Bitcoin assets to help further develop, develop the Bitcoin community, to give back, to also make money. And this is their project, which is a worldwide global hunt for these keys. David Wong is also known for being the founder, if you can say, of the Hard, that's proof of work, the Hardcore Fund, is a dev fund for the developers of the volunteers for the Bitcoin community, the Bitcoin Core community, to be able to fund and help them out, give them funds, because they were most of them doing this voluntarily. A lot of them are not getting paid, a few of them are sponsored, but not all of them. And they also have Jess Wang, who is also a member of the Game Makers. She does a lot of tweets. She's the one who's pretty much been announcing what are called Manhunts. I will go into that in a moment. So those are the three key people. This is a global game in which you have to basically have a kind of understanding of text-based adventure games, a little bit of cyberpunk influence, have an understanding of pop culture, and combine all these different types of games, skill sets, networking, all these different skills that you could potentially have to unlock these different codes, to obtain the keys, basically solve these different puzzles, obtain the keys, and you can win this Bitcoin prize. So how you play is you go to the website, and this is where the keys are released. You have these clues on the right hand side, you unlock the information from the clue. Sometimes they have announcements on the Twitter. You can go to the Telegram, the official Telegram, all these are linked in the show notes, or Reddit to obtain some information. Basically, what you have is you have a group of people who are trying to solve these different puzzle pieces. The faster you get there, the greater chances of accessing these type of keys. So what are those keys? I'll get to them in a moment, but let's talk about the clues. The clues can come in different formats. The logic-based clues, where you have to use some internet saving, some thinking, some logic to solve the puzzle. For example, the business key is a logic key-based solution, if you will. Some are group keys or contest keys, where you have to work with a group of people to win a contest in order to obtain the key. You have some code breaking, as well as some cultural awareness keys. It's one of those kind of combo keys where you indicate the concept of your cultural knowledge. In this case, it was knowing who New Order, but this is one of the codes that was developed for their album. And using code breaking to be able to solve for the key. And then there's cryptographic keys, where you have to have computer-based knowledge to be able to and break down the information from the clue to be able to obtain the key. And then there's these combination keys, where you have to use the ability of internet surfing, a little bit of computer knowledge to obtain the key, as well as performing a task, where you have to find a particular object, give it to a particular individual, which are called field agents, at a geolocation, and a part of it, another key is a geolocation key, which is, you also have what are called geolocation keys, in which you find a particular person or a QR code at a specific location, a specific time, and then you obtain that particular key. There are also these manhunts along the way where you could earn prizes. One took place in Taipei for the rare key, where there was a $1,000 bounty available for anyone who found that geolocation key. There was one in New York, and there's supposed to be more of these as the game progresses, in which you can obtain small amounts of Bitcoin at different prize levels along the way for yourself or your coin. When you finally solve for the clue to obtain the key, you will see typically what you'll see if it's not a geolocation key is you go to the decryptor page, you enter the passphrase, and then this type of format will appear for that particular key. There are different numbers, and sometimes the keys also have, as you look here, different little word phrases at the bottom that could potentially be clues for further keys down the road. Everything pretty much in this game is a clue or a hint. Some of these keys have been interlocked, some have not, but you just have to pay attention to even the smallest detail can be the hint you need to solve for a particular puzzle. Here's a couple of tools that you can use as reference. The website that keeps track of any satellite messages that may be conveyed by the game makers. And another tool is Calyrinics, that has a lot of the different hacking tools or cryptographic tools that are just embedded in the OS itself that help you to be able to do some of the cryptographic keys. It's a common reference OS and all the different clans and individuals utilized to be able to solve those cryptographic keys. All in all, it's a very fun game. It can be very taxing at times because you're dealing with all these different skill sets. Sometimes you feel like you don't have a skill set, and that might be the case. But it could be a different key or a different code out there that you might be really good at, like logic codes, that particular logic-based key. You might be very good at networking. You might have, you know, friends and family globally and be able to build these geolocation keys around the world and be able to take time out of your day and get that key for the clan or for yourself. There are contest keys, maybe you'll be able to participate in a group activity. There's cultural-based knowledge for some of these different keys. There can be combo keys that you observe or notice something about a particular key reference. So like, oh, that looks like this or that, and that might be able to help your clan or you as an individual be able to reference and be able to access or solve the puzzle and get the key. It's not too late to play this game. Many of the keys have been publicly published, or a few that are not. There are some that have been solved, and that you can still solve for yourself, except for otherwise indicated by the game makers themselves, so they'll say that the key can be solved. For the most part, the cryptographic keys and the combination of cryptographic keys are the ones you can still pretty much solve at this time. Geolocation keys and contest keys are one-off, so the reward is done for that point. So you can join any clan, and there is a few public clans, as well as the different official channels so you can communicate and form your own group, join an existing group, or work on your own. It's very highly recommended not to work on your own for the simple fact that you have to have all these various skill sets, if you will, to be able to obtain the solutions for these different puzzles. I hope that this helps you. I hope you have an understanding of the game. I hope you have some fun. Join us. Join the different groups. This is not a sprint. It is a marathon. It's supposed to take about a year to do. And who knows? It could be 6 months. It could be 7 months. It could be the first 400 keys. It could be the first 600, 700. It could come down to the wire of 1,000 keys for people to be able to solve because there could be keys that are unsolvable. Who knows? It's supposed to be an adventure. It's supposed to be community building. And most importantly, there is a prize at the end of the rainbow, if you will, of potential earning either as an individual or with your group, or clan, $1 million USD equivalent in Bitcoin. My name is Roja Shai. This is Soshi's Treasure Hunters, and on with the hunt.
I were to offer you $1 million.